Thanks for joining us with this video today. We are going to just go over a brief overview of those 2018 Farm Bill programs, ARC PL and PLC. We have Matthew Berg, who's an agricultural program specialist with our USDA Farm Service Agency. And so I'm really grateful for you to join us today, Matthew, and just, let producers know changes for 2025 or those dates and what they need to be looking at when they're choosing between the options that they have available for them. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to you.
All right, you bet. Thank you, Anne, for having me on today. We appreciate it. Basically, we're just a high-level overview of 2025 ARC PLC election and enrollment today. As many of you know, this was a one-year extension, so we don't really have a lot of changes that are coming with it this year. A few key points we'll hit on is effective reference price. That's always in relation to the PLC program. And then ARC County, we have some sites that folks can go get updated data for this coming year. But otherwise, we'll just go through our annual election enrollment process and kick it off from there. So, first slide we have here is the 2025 general provisions. The election for program year 25 producers, you have the option to change the current election on the farm. By either crop by crop for ARC County and PLC or by the farm for ARC IC. Enrollment, to be eligible for payment, producers must complete their enrollment contract for each of their farms. And the note here on this is that both processes are completed on the same contract. So any election change that a producer wants to make before April 15th, they will also do that on their enrollment form on that contract by that April 15th date as well. The deadline to complete both election enrollments for 2025, as I stated before, is April 15th of 2025. Any election change can be changed or modified through that deadline, and payments, if calculated for the 2025 year, are going to be issued in October of 2026. So same process we've had over the last two farm bills. We always are lo looking at paying things a year behind when the election and enrollment actually took place. The reason for this is because it allows that 2025 market year average price to be set after the 2025 marketing year ends, which that is August 31st of 2026. Some 25 general provisions for the ARC PLC, payment eligibility and payment limitation. These have not changed from previous years. Producers must meet these requirements to be eligible for the payment processing if it triggers. You must be actively engaged in farming. We do look at your cash rent tenant if that's applicable. The adjusted gross income level, more commonly known as the AGI, is still $900,000 for the program this year. We do take a look at the 1026 conservation compliance provisions and as well as our foreign person requirements. The payment limitation for the program is staying the same. It's a 125, or excuse me, 125,000 payment limit. And this is also going to apply to, with direct attribution and common attribution. So direct attribution, we're going to be looking at folks, whether you farm as an individual or you farm as a entity, such as an LLC or a corporation, our payments are going to go down to that individual's social security number through that direct attribution process. For the program sign-up process, there's a number of options that folks have when trying to complete their 2025 ARC PLC election enrollment process. Our county offices are equipped to be able to email these contracts to you. They can also be mailed. Producers can contact the county office to make an appointment, which is the one that we prefer just because that way we can have a conversation with folks at the counter, answer any questions that folks might have, and also make sure that we have all of that payment limitation eligibility stuff up to date on file and correctly loaded in our offices. To complete any election changes and enrollment, we just ask that you give us a call, email your local FSA office, and we can discuss further, any potential questions that folks might have with that. Getting back into program election here, we'll get into the details a little bit about PLC, ARC County, and ARC Individual. For the election process, again, folks have until April 15th of 2025 to make the election change. And we like to emphasize this, that it's a two-part deal on one contract. So for the election process, that has to be completed by April 15th. When looking at this, any producer with an interest in cropland on the farm is required to sign that new election form. So if you have a 50-50 situation, we need both of those producers signing that contract stating that they want to change that election. The election process is only locked in for the 2025 program year. Again, that was a statute change with this 18 farm bill that we would have an election process every year. So with this extension, that rolls forward again as well. If no new election change is requested, then we're keeping that 2024 election on file and we're going to roll that forward to the 2025 year. And again, back to my point, even if that election rolls forward, you still have to complete enrollment for this 2025 year to be eligible for a potential payment down the road. My next slide here is the 2025 projected MYA prices. Currently, this was from January 10th of 25, and I have highlighted just the two primary crops that we have here in Iowa. So for corn, the market year average price is currently projected at 425, and soybeans is 1020. Obviously, we're in a bit of a rally here the last couple days or last couple weeks. So those are always subject to change. These are just strictly projections from our national office, but it's something to keep in mind when we're looking at our county. Program election options. So we have the price loss coverage PLC. This is our price-based program. So with the price base, we select that by base crop on the farm. The agricultural risk ARC revenue based program. We have two options under that. That's ARC County and ARC Individual. ARC County is just a yield level, and we're still looking at the base crop on the farm, but it goes by the county yield, is where we're looking at there. And for ARC IC, that is yield level, and that is by farm for all base crops. And the thing that we like to note, and we'll remind folks about this at the counter this year as well, is that RMA's SCO product is not allowed with either of the ARC revenue-based protection programs. So if those are elected for the crop in that county, you will not be able to get SCO coverage through your RMA agent. PLC, the price loss coverage, that would be the only option allowed with that SCO product. For price loss coverage, payments are issued when the effective reference price is less than the effective, excuse me, the effective price for the marketing year average price is less than the effective reference price. So payments are going to be issued on 85% of the base acres of that covered commodity elected to PLC. And you can elect that by base crop. So what we mean by that is if your farm has, bean base, corn base, there's still some oat, sorghum base out there, you can elect each individual crop to a PLC program. This may be combined with RMA's SCO crop insurance product, and the payments are made regardless of planting a covered commodity. So just because you have only corn base on a farm, if in your rotation you're planting beans this coming year, you would still be eligible for a corn base payment if you selected PLC for your corn base. And that effective reference price that I was referring to in the last slide, this is a snippet of our data from the USDA ARC PLC data site. So you can see here again, I highlighted corn and soybeans. The effective reference price for corn this year is 426, and for beans, it's 966. For those of you that follow this program pretty closely, the statute, the farm bill was originally written to have 370 for corn, and I believe it was 840 for beans. So we are up quite a bit. And the farm bill statute has it written in there for this to expand. So in years where we have higher prices, different things, this kind of tracks with how prices actually are in the field. So that's where we see this raise to 426 from that old statute of 370. is because that statute in the Farm Bill has been triggered. So effective reference price for PLC this year, corn 426 and beans is going to be 966. Jumping back over to Arc County, again, nothing has changed with this program for this year. Payments are made when that actual revenue is less than our Arc County guarantee, and we're looking at 86% of the benchmark for those covered commodities. So that county yield data is used in Arc County, not the individual or producer farm data. The 2023 Arc County benchmark revenues, those were posted to the National Arc PLC website. We do also have those posted for 24 and again for 25. They have historical and current year data on that. The Arc CO benchmark revenue guaranteed and actual revenue is then calculated according to the physical location of that farm tract. And the payment rate can be no higher than 10% of the Arc County benchmark revenue for that covered commodity. We're making payments made on the 85% of the base acres of that covered commodity. And payments are made regardless of the planting of the covered commodity, like I stated earlier. This election may be made by cover commodity, by base crop on that farm for Arc County as well. Arc individual, using the same base information as we did for Arc County, the payments are made when that Arc IC actual revenue is less than the Arc IC guarantee. We're looking at 86% of the benchmark for that one as well. On all cover commodities, on all farms enrolled in Arc IC in the state for that producer. So the payment rate is the difference of the Arc IC guarantee and that Arc IC actual revenue, but it cannot be any higher than 10% of the Arc IC benchmark revenue for all cover commodities on the farm. Payments are made on 65% of the total base acres on the farm, and the election is by farm for Arc IC. So kind of just a brief overview here again, 2025 enrollment deadline is April 15th of 2025. 25 election and enrollment can be completed on the same contract. So for PLC and for Arc County, the contract form number is a CCC 866. And for Arc IC, a CCC 862 will be completed. Producers requesting a share in base acres must sign the applicable contracts. Zero share cash rent owner signatures are not required for annual enrollment. We're only looking at folks who have interest in cropland for election and interest in base for enrollment. So that's a little bit of a different caveat there. And producers may participate or not participate on a year-by-year basis for this program. So a few program data and decision tools here coming up next. The data that I referred to before, folks can head to this link. This has all of our program data, including yields, prices, benchmark revenues. Everything is broken down by county and by state, or excuse me, by state and by county. So you can drill down to look and see exactly your area of the state and how those benchmark revenues have been updated from year to year. And I provided the link there in that slide. Some more decision tools, as Anne and her team will probably go over a little bit more in depth. We have all of our data on the ISU Extension Ag Decision Maker. Texas A&M still has some good Farm Bill decision tools out there as well, and so does the University of Illinois. And I think that concludes the presentation there.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Matthew. With that, I was just going to say, is there anything else you wanted to share?
I don't. We just like to emphasize that if folks have questions, call our offices. Our staffs out in the field are getting ready to go. We've started sign up as of January 21st. I know people are excited to get things rolling. So any questions, contact your local FSA office. We'd love to help you out.
For sure. Thank you so much, Matthew, for being here with us. I would encourage folks to, yes, ask questions, make sure that you're making the best decision for your operation this year. With those price changes, like people do need to, if they've just kind of let the choice kind of move year to year and just done the enrollment process, this might be a year to kind of reassess what their best options are.